Hello everyone, this is Ayushi Bhatnagar and today we have with us one of the most eminent personalities of media world today. She is none other than Ms. Ritul Joshi, news anchor, Aaj Tak. Hello and I welcome you here.
Thank you, but that should be ex Aaj Tak. I'm on a sabbatical right now, so I'm no longer working. I've taken a break and I'm on my own.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful information. Okay, ma'am, my first question to you is, you have covered so many beats, be it politics, sports, environmental, entertainment, etc., etc.
I have never covered entertainment.
You? Okay.
I haven't.
Okay. So, which has been your favorite beat and why?
Any story which excites me.
Something which is interesting for you, find interesting and you start
with? A lot of stuff that I have done was very challenging. It really tested my patience, my journalistic skills, my endurance, and my ability to connect with my viewers. So all those stories, there have been many, you know, it's very difficult. It's like a mother picking out her favorite child. So it's very difficult to pick out my favorite, but yeah, across these years, whatever I've done, I've really enjoyed doing it. And that is probably the reason why I stayed on for so long and continued doing my work.
So you have always been very keen to learn something new every time.
That should be the idea.
Okay. Now, you have been into this profession for almost 1.5 decades, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, precisely 15 years. Yeah, you're
finally
right.
Finally, something I got right about you. So, what you consider is the biggest achievement of your career so far?
It's too short a career to start counting my achievements. 15 years is nothing.
But still, you find that, but still there must be something that you thought that, yes, this is something that I've always wanted to do and I made it. Something challenging that you got.
See, if you're a journalist and especially if you are a TV journalist, then every day is a challenge. Every minute actually, because, you know, people make a lot of fun of it and talk about breaking news, but that breaking news can actually get onto your nerves and it can actually hamper the way you function. So every day, every minute is a challenge, and also it has potential to throw up something new, which is something I really find exciting about TV news, that, you know, it exposes you to a new story every day. So that is what kept me going, and to become a part of many, I wouldn't call them path-breaking stories, but yes, they were important stories. And, you know, maybe 20 years down the line, if we turn back and look at the history of the country, we would all realize that probably these were some very important watermark events in the history of the country. And I was very lucky to be a part of those events.
All right. So, ma'am, my next question is pretty technical. What do you think is the impact of, first, corporatization of news, and second, commercialization of news on the quality of news that is being on air?
You'll have to explain that a bit to me. When you say commercialization, what exactly do you mean?
I mean, like the advertisements are more...
Otherwise, how will you sustain? Somebody has to pay the money to run the news channel. But so, you know, yeah, I think these are certain aspects which should now just be taken. It should be a part of the industry that at the end of the day, running a channel requires a lot of money. It's not that you pick up few thousand rupees and if you know a bit about your equipment, your machines, everything, the operational cost of running a channel is huge. So somebody has to foot the bill. So at the end of the day, you have to obviously make sure that you meet the cost. So how do you do it? You do it by advertising. This is how almost all businesses operate, don't they?
Right.
You know, you have to get in money. You have to make sure that the operation is unhampered. It works smoothly. So that I think is a non-issue, because when you say commercialization, all you are saying is you get enough finances to get the channel running, to get the channel working. So I really don't think, you know, that one should now get back into that issue of money and advertisements, because if you don't have money, you don't have a news channel. So take your pick. Either you don't have commercials and anything else on the channel, and second is you don't have a channel at all.
But do you think that all these things impact the quality of news? I mean,
no.
Does it affect?
More money a channel has, I think, better the quality would be. You can probably do more special shows.
So the more real news you get.
You can invest more in news gathering. You can invest more in TV works a lot on how the visuals are secured and how they are played up. So maybe you can invest in better equipment. You can invest in better cameras, better machines, better manpower.
Okay. Do you really think that online journalism can pose a threat for television journalism in the coming years?
When you talk about online journalism, are you talking about video streaming and IP television?
Yes, definitely.
Technology is something which is bound to improve and change. And getting a new technology does not necessarily mean that the older technology would die. Probably we'll have to look at ways of reinventing ourselves, you know. We'll have to look at ways of how to be relevant, how to stay in the business. There will be innovations, there will be new ways, but no, to think that television would be, probably you'll start getting television on your mobile phone.
Right, we are getting it.
Yeah, but it's 3G, so the quality is not that good. Maybe once you have 4G, you might probably have a better access to TV. So, you know, you never know. It might just merge with the internet and probably come out with a completely new product, which is symbiotic, where networks in collaboration with TV, which is happening right now also. Okay. You get your news on your mobile.
Definitely.
Yeah.
In fact, even I, in the morning, I switch on my mobile.
Exactly.
And look for that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Mom, you started your career with Doordarshan Subah Savere. Then you...
No. I started my career with a news agency.
ANI.
ANI, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then in electronic media I was talking about.
Yeah.
Then
ANI is an electronic news agency. There are two versions of
but
ANI.
But as an anchor.
One is print and the other one is the electronic agency.
Yes.
ANI, the electronic agency, is the biggest electronic news gathering agency in the country. So that's where I started off.
Yeah. But as a news anchor, I think Subah Savere was the first
one. Yeah, that's where I made my television debut.
Right.
You might call it so. Yeah.
Right. And then you switched over to Zee News. That inside story, investigative program.
It was one of the shows I did. I was actually a reporter on that team.
Okay.
And I would anchor other news also.
Okay.
And I would anchor my show, of course.
And then now you were on Aaj Tak for some years. So which was the best experience? I mean, the Doordarshan.
In terms of where I worked.
Yes.
That's difficult to say because you know because when you change an organization, it's also because. Maybe you're wanting to try out new things.
Absolutely.
So, you know, wherever you get more opportunities and whatever you feel is more suited to your area of interest would be what you'll pick up. So, this is what happened. This is how the change of job happened.
Okay, so just
and I enjoyed my time everywhere. I wouldn't say that, you know, I didn't like it here or I hated that organization. No, never. And each organization taught me something. You know, it was a learning process which just the graph kept going up. So I think it was nice working in all those places. That's why I was working there in the first place. Okay. Otherwise, why would I join them?
Okay. Well, before winding up, my one last question to you is, you are the role model for many of the aspiring students.
Really?
Yes,
okay.
You are. For many of the aspiring students who want to be a journalist and especially a news anchor in future. So what are the skills and competencies required to be a good news anchor?
No compromises on reading. Being well informed, you have to know before you're there in front of the, because you know, TV, if it gives you instant gratification, instant success, instant fame, it can also be an instant disaster. Yeah, it's not like a newspaper where you have time, you have the entire evening to write down your story. If you're on TV, it's there. Whatever you have to do it at that very moment. So for that, it's very important that you're well. See, it's not possible for an anchor to know everything about everything. No human being can possibly ever do that. But it's important to be generally aware of things, to read a lot, to know. And also, I think you need to be able to communicate. Because at the end of the day, television is all about communicating. It's all about connecting with people. So that is another thing which I think is very important, that a desire to connect, an ability to connect, and also being well-read and informed.
Okay. That was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for giving your valuable time to us.
Thank you.
That was all for today. Thank you.